kind of world would it be if we let ourselves see through somebody else's eyes? If we let ourselves look stupid and make mistakes every chance we got? What if we wanted to fail? What if we took the risk? Life's a risk every single day. You allow yourself to be completely present in the moment with someone else. Will they make fun of you? Reject you? The way today works, you sit down with someone and greet them, and then usually they'll immediately get onto their phone. It's just easier, right? Bury yourself in social media or an episode on Netflix, and you don't have to interact with anyone. It takes less energy, and there's no risk of getting hurt or feeling dumb. It's a big risk to actually be willing to be with someone in the same space and the same time. How many times have you really felt like, okay, we're here, together? This is us. This is our moment that we'll get. We won't ever get it again. That's hard. We kind of swim through life like those memories will come when they come, when actually every moment could be that way. What if you miss out on the best moment of your life? Would you rather be on your phone when you might have a chance at a new opportunity? When you're truly immersed in the moment, interacting with someone, it gives you the chance to learn about them and yourself through the way they react to you. You see who they are and you see yourself reflected in how they respond to you. It's a two-way mirror. As a theater professor, my entire life revolves around this concept. Being present in the moment is absolutely necessary to convince your audience that you are truly the character. Being vulnerable is required. You have to be willing to invest yourself in the present moment. A class I took taught me this vulnerability and how to allow myself to be open enough to experience this. This class was mask acting, and I spent an entire semester with this one mask. It's a very distorted mask, with one eye drooping, part of it painted red and brown, and an asymmetrical mouth. When you do a mask class, you do all kinds of physical exploration. It's amazing how real things can get when you've got 2 hours and you're in a mask, and all of a sudden, nobody else is there. It's just me inside the mask. So one day, our class couldn't be in our normal studio. We had to go out to the fitness center, and the teacher wanted all of us to have partners for this mirror exercise, where you look into each other's eyes, and you move your bodies, and you follow your partner. The idea is that the two people become one, and boundaries dissolve. If someone's watching you do this, you would never know who was leading. And it's so hard because your vision is limited, for one thing, and you're not yourself. You've internalized this other face. That day, I did not have a partner, so my teacher asked me to turn to face these glass windows. I could see myself in them, and as I'm doing the exercise and listening to his coaching, people are walking past me on the other side of the glass. And there was a moment where I realized I'm not me, Bethany, but Bethany and my mask. It is so visible. I have a mask on, and yet I felt so naked, so seen. I could have, in retrospect, decided that it was too much, that it was too scary. It was so scary. I could have dropped out of the mask, but I stayed in because she, my mask, my character, that was one of her experiences. If I dropped out of the mask, I would have deserted her. Instead, I stayed in, and because I stayed in, I discovered something I would not have discovered otherwise. This emotion, whatever it is that I felt so strongly, it constructed something inside me that's made me the person I am and the person I have been as other characters. I played a character who was a schizophrenic and an extraordinary artist. Lindsay's her name. And Lindsay doesn't speak in sentences that you'd understand. She speaks in phrases that she's heard throughout her life. And some of those phrases include things like, "Praise God, blessings flow." She says this a lot. In the play, she's a paranoid schizophrenic, so there are moments where she's calm, but others where she's full on in an episode. And the first time I read that part, I knew immediately who she was. I think she was my mask. If I hadn't experienced my mask, I would not have understood that character. Discovering that, the tears that come from those two instances, they never came from anger or hatred. They came from the discovery of vulnerability, In the play, Lindsay has been painting all of these paintings, trying to get her brother's attention. She doesn't consciously realize that's what she's doing, but when he finally comes about at the end of the play, she's spread all the paintings she's done on the floor. I then look at my brother as Lindsay and say, "Blessings flow." It's her way of saying, "I love you." It's this incredibly deep comprehension of how humans maybe can't always say what they want to say. They can't always articulate to someone that they love them. People are broken. We are all broken. We all act like we're not, but we are. Having that experience of having to be inside, having to embody a person who's incredibly broken, yet also incredibly beautiful, that's worth the risk. It has to do with empathy. It has to do with being willing to put yourself in somebody else's shoes, to see life the way they might see life. Do not assume that you know necessarily what's happening with a human being. We need to know that I have brokenness. I have to remember that. I should never allow myself to think that I know everything or that I'm fine. There's always going to be a part of me that hurts. But if that's true for me, isn't that true for everyone? We all walk around like we know what the heck we're doing, like everything's okay. And probably most of the time we feel like we're okay, right? But the reality is that we are not okay. There's things that have affected us that we don't talk about. And I think what theater does is it allows us a kind of safe way to examine those challenges. I've had people ask me before, if you had to play an evil character, what would you do? Well, I don't know that I've played a completely evil character, but I have played hard people who have hard perspectives on life. Right now I'm playing Sister Aloysius, who is a woman who comes off as very stern and careless of anyone else's feelings. Deep down, she's just as broken as anyone else. She's just trying to make sure other people don't experience the brokenness that she fears. It's very interesting. This idea of what makes up the things that we hide, the things that we deny. You get people into a room. Like when you go see a movie, you're in an audience. You're watching patterns of light on a screen, which is great. I love movies. When you're with an audience that's very responsive, you sort of feel that camaraderie. But when you're in a theater with live actors on stage, what we fail to acknowledge as an audience is that this is a risky thing. These people on stage could come out into the audience and talk to us. They can make us do things, ask us to come and help them on stage. We're all in the same space. We're all human beings. We're all breathing the same air. We've agreed to form a community for 2 hours, a community that will likely never exist again in the same way. This is huge, right? That's a leap of faith if people understand that it is. You are in an audience. You are forced to be truly present in the moment. However, in everyday life, that's not the case. It's easy to hide through different escape mechanisms, such as our phones. Is this really worth it? Imagine what the world would be like if we let ourselves be vulnerable, if we let ourselves take the risk of just being there. Who would you get the chance to know that you maybe missed out on before? We're all broken in some way. No matter who you are or how much you pretend that you aren't, we can connect with each other if we agree to take the risk of being in the moment. I challenge you to do this. Be vulnerable. Be present. Be in the moment. Take the risk. You never know what you might learn about someone else or even about yourself. What could seeing through someone else's eyes do for them and you? Thank you.